If your warm season grass undergoes a prolonged period of drought, it may go into summer dormancy. Your lawn will stop growing. Allowing it to go dormant is always an option when you don't want to water on a regular basis during these hottest and driest weeks of the year.
If your grass is turning brown, it's not that big of a deal, because when it's turning brown, that's just the blades.
While summer dormant grass may appear dead to the naked eye, the growth area inside the plant, known as the crown, is still alive. Keep the crown moist and pay close attention to your lawn's color. In most cases, it will come back once regular rains return.
Our typical dormant colors is a tanner type brown versus like a just a dry gray brown.
As we get closer to fall and dormancy, your watering practices can have an impact on the health of your lawn. Water your lawn only when you need to. Overwatering can also harm your lawn by creating root rot, suffocation, and other undesired conditions. You may want to use a moisture meter to determine if the lawn needs water.
It's really important to know about your irrigation system and know what type of watering amount is going to be coming out of that irrigation system so we can properly water our grass only when it's needed.
Scale back watering and fertilizer applications in fall to minimize the risk of diseases. Grass growth begins to slow when temperatures get below 74 degrees. It usually goes dormant when temperatures are consistently under 60 degrees. Once it does go dormant, it will stay that way throughout the winter.